Yes. He's entered the building. Grammy Award winning. La Familia. Responsible for over 100 million in sales. Easily. Easily. Easily.
Family.
Destiny's Child. Easily. That wasn't nothing for him.
Light work. Light work.
GMB. That wasn't nothing for him.
Light work. Light work.
Mary J. Blige. That wasn't nothing for him.
Light work. Light work.
Shakira. That wasn't nothing for him.
Let's work.
The Fugees. That wasn't nothing for him.
That was so dope.
When you listen to some of these artists and how they've been able to combine dance music and island music and different flavors, he was doing it first. That was nothing for him.
Light work. Light work.
Off
light
the top
work.
Of the head, he's sick with it. That's nothing for him.
Light work, light work.
How
work.
Many instruments you play? He played multiple ones. That's nothing for him.
I don't play none.
It's my brethren. He ran for president.
I didn't.
That was nothing for him.
Yeah. Light work, light work.
Yeah, that was kind of crazy.
That was that wasn't light work right there. That got kind of
that was heavy work.
You heard
yeah.
me pull
yeah,
out.
Remember that? The one and only Wyclef Jean is here, ladies and
what
gentlemen.
What up, families? Families. Not boule. What's good, families?
What up, clef?
Man, I'm so good. I'm so blessed, man. Good to see you, family.
Good to see you.
You know,
as
we
well.
Had our talk.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, we was at South By.
That's
and
right.
And I was like, yo, I'm in the zone.
Yeah.
I'm in this zone again. I'm in this music zone. It's coming. It's coming. And so it's definitely fun, and it's an honor, and it's dope. And then I be telling icons, man, you can't take nothing for granted. Every time you coming back, I got this joint, the ring. You heard
wait,
it yet?
Wait, 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 hold up. You know what? Let's get into this. Hold up. I got you. Don't say nothing. You're going to ruin it. We do this thing called lyrical breakdown,
oh,
clef.
Shit.
And where we break down the lyrics to certain songs.
Oh, wow.
Don't say nothing, clef. I'm right there with you. Let's do it.
I don't get it.
What exactly don't you get?
Breaking down the lyrics you may not understand.
What the hell did you just say?
It's the Lyrical Breakdown.
I can break it down like whatever you want.
On Sway in the Morning.
Clef, where you going? We gonna break down the lyrics?
Yeah.
You got this new song. Got this new song called The Ring.
The Ring.
The intro goes, it's been 7 years. I left at the height of my career. Man, I'm coming back. He told me this last year when he came on the South by Southwest stage and performed
yeah.
live.
I heard it.
Remember that?
I told you.
Okay.
Remember you set it off.
We set it off.
You remember you did that Motai, when I did that Motai freestyle,
mm-hmm.
that went viral, remember?
Exactly.
Then they was like, who's this new rapper Sway bringing on?
They
that's what the kids were saying.
They thought you were brand new.
Yeah.
But that's okay.
I love it.
Right? Because it's a refresher course.
Come on, Steve Austin, let's go.
He said, I'm starting all over again, don't matter what I did before. But it does matter what you did before.
Yeah, but what happens is when you in that frame of mind, right?
Yeah.
And every time you're trying to come back, it's like the Super Bowl or it's like the NBA. Everyone respects the record. Like, y'all all love the record. But what happens is when a representative shows up on the radio
mm-hmm.
and I ain't there, for example, and they trying to get an ad on the record, right? They're like, damn, clef, yo, you sure he still got it?
Yeah.
So it's almost like every time you step in the ring, if you want to box, we all know what the record is, but it's all about what you're going to do right now. You know what I mean? Like my daughter, you know, her reality is different than mine, you know, because she's sitting in a movie theater, the crib, and mm-hmm. I'm like, Angie, you know you got it easy. Your dad used to ride her. And she finishes, yeah, Dad, I know you used to ride a donkey back in 70s, 80s, but we're in 2017, Daddy, right now, you know.
But let me ask you this. Young Thug made a song. And he named it after you. And that's almost paying homage. And then, in turn, you came back and he appeared in one of your songs.
Mm-hmm.
That's the bridge, I think. That's a healthy bridge to me that needs to happen from a newer generation artist and somebody who's been here and established. What have you learned from him and your dealings with him?
Well, the thing is, it's to your point, right? Remember when Quincy and Michael was working together, mm-hmm. there was just information. And to your point, that's always the gap.
Yeah.
And I feel like the you know, what I get from Thug, when he was calling, you know, he tracked everybody down.
Mm-hmm.
Then Leo finally got a hold of Madeline. When I went down there, I walked in, and he was like, yo, clef, his tattoo on his chest say Haiti. He like, yo, man, my project's name Haiti. We even got this handshake called Haiti. And he's like, yo, you know, when I talk about you, basically, it's almost like he knew more about me than I knew about myself.
Wow.
And then he was like, so it's almost like when I met Quincy, how I just studied the parts of Quincy that I needed to study. And he was like, yo, you know, this trap music, I really just learned it. And he was like, yo, let me show you what I do, what I got. Mm-hmm. And then he starts to play me all of these records. Melody to the T, because you know I'm a melody
You're
dude.
A melody guy.
So he starts to play melody, acoustic guitars, 808s. So
Thugger
I got
was playing playing it?
No, he was playing these records that had acoustic guitars and all that. And once again, these kids, they're starting to pick up, like he picked up an acoustic guitar. Like I'm sending him his first guitar, gonna send him a guitar lesson. So what happens is these kids are reaching out, right? And what happens is for you to get real magic, for you to get Thriller, it's you have to cross generations.
Yes.
The reinvention has to cross generations. So it's almost like I can try to bring myself back as much as I want, but until that kid who's 20-something does a song called Wyclef Jean, and all the kids now go online, and now they researching like Wyclef for the last couple of weeks. Now they know who the Fugees is. They're like, oh, that's the guy who did Hips Don't Lie from Shakira. So the kids now basically tied up. And that is the most important thing with the generation gap. Because sometimes I watch Twitter feuds where generations fight over generations. Like they're like, man, y'all generation, y'all not rapping, man. That's called a mumbo rap. Y'all don't, you know. Now keep in mind, every generation moves on a frequency. And it's so important that you understand that, because those who don't understand that, they get left out.
We call them fossils.
Yeah, yeah, they get left out.
They become fossils.
You know what I'm saying? So it's because remember, we was coming up, there was like, what's this funny dance they doing?
Yeah.
We was doing the hammer. We was doing the cabbage patch. And they was looking at us like we were weird. The only difference when we was coming out, the variety was bigger,
was
right?
Was broader.
Yeah. So you can have five acts here, five acts here. But the difference is, I tell people, if you want underground rap and you looking for spitters, they didn't go nowhere. It just translated to the rap league.
Yeah.
So if you looking for the underground now, just go to URL, King of the Dot. You're going to get your favorite MCs, you know? But this space is a commercial space. And Thugger said something deep. I think he has a brother or a cousin who more rhymes like Nas or something.
Yeah.
And then what's deep about it is you see each kid take their style of hip-hop that they like. And that's all we did, right?
That's all we did.
That's true.
Wyclef is here. The new EP is called
Juve.
Juve. What does that mean?
Juve is the start of the carnival. So in Brooklyn, right, the day before we hit that Eastern, Parkway, that night.
Yeah.
That night when it goes down, the key is you can't sleep that night. The drinking, the partying, it's literally, you know that you're going to be up for 3 days straight.
Yeah.
And so the Juve is what would be the start of the carnival, because Carnival 3 is coming in June. So this is us saying, like, okay, this is the start of the carnival.
Okay.
Right?
Now, you got Thuggers on it on the I Swear song, but if you get, like, the, what is it, the Deluxe Edition, and then you have the Pledge Music Deluxe Package.
Yeah.
That has a song called Love, Peace, Happiness featuring Lauryn Hill.
Oh, is there? I didn't know that.
You didn't know?
Did you? Nah.
No, you dead ass?
Nah, I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
They added that?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
But come on, Clef. You okay and everything.
I didn't know that part. I didn't okay that. That's probably Madeline Nelson, the CEO. So we got a Lauryn Hill track? Are you sure? Let me see. I'm going to take the promotion. I'm going to take the promotion as you give it to me, man. All right.
See it.
Pledge Music Deluxe Package. Oh, wow. Yeah.
You didn't know that.
I'll go with it, baby.
Yeah.
I'll take that old Flatbush mentality. Right. I'll take whatever you're going to give me.
Right.
Something sounds unbelievable right now. You didn't know there was a Lauryn Hill song on your own project.
No, what happens is this is what's called the Deluxe, right?
Okay.
So in the Deluxe with Pledge, they are allowed to pull anything from the past, right?
So that's a past.
Yeah, yeah. Anything that they want to pull, because sometimes within the deluxe package, like you see, Gone to November, Divine Sorrow, Killing Me Softly.
Okay.
So it's almost like they constantly pull blasts of the past. Okay. But the one that I cleared that I was like, make sure, no matter what y'all do in the past, is a French song called Ne Me Quitte Pas, which was done by Nina Simone, by Lauren, by different people. So I was like, no matter what y'all do, make sure I have a complete French song on the deluxe.
Well, you didn't seem as excited as I was that I thought you and Lauren came back together.
I would have been excited if it was present, you know what I mean?
So, not past.
Yeah, yeah, you feel me, right?
Present will never happen?
Well, we can't never say never, man.
Yeah.
I learned that one.
Have y'all ever talked about
We've talked in recent times. I mean, all the way to like the other day, I was on the reel, right? And I was like, yo, I was like, man, you know, I be feeling like I'm the only Fuji that y'all could get access to, right? To ask this question to, right?
That's
so pretty then, much.
You feel me? So I was like, you know what? So I turned it around on the reel. I was like, you know what? Y'all, Lauryn and Pras is watching this right now. You know, y'all want this Fuji reunion. Y'all let them know. And, of course, the people started going insanely crazy and wanting that. And like I said, once again,
I don't even know if it's a Fuji reunion as much as I'd like to see you two work. Whether it's a Fuji project or just,
well, I mean, you the culture, though. Like, you just want to see us in the studio doing something. You know what I mean?
I mean, okay. Well, look, let's get back to the day. Wyclef Jean.
It can't happen.
Heather, you
know. It's probably going to take Dave Chappelle.
Dave
Chappelle. Suzette Williams.
Yes. I'm real. Big shout out to Suzette. I mean, Suzette is one of the oracles in the come up, like bringing us all up.
Well, okay.
She's listening right now.
Yes.
So I shouldn't get this pressure. Suzette should get. Suzette got the plug, man.
Hey, let's call Suzette. Let's see if she pick up.
Suzette got the plug.
Call on speaker.
She gonna pick up your call, HB.
She might not, man. She might
be
listening.
Slay's taking advantage. All right, my best friend. He got that Brooklyn mentality too.
Yeah.
Flatbush.
And I wanna meet these young artists that you brought here today. What I like about them, I see it in their eye, man. It is raw. It's natural. They hungry.
Yeah.
I don't know what they do. I know they came with you.
Yeah, yeah.
So that alone is stamp enough for me.
Yeah.
Can you introduce them to us?
Well, of course, we got young Jazzy. Jazzy.
Yeah, I go by the name of Jazzy Amra.
Where you from, Jazzy Amra?
I'm from the Bronx.
You feel that in?
Yeah.
Hold on. Well, if I got this. Go by the name of Jazzy. So, how long you been involved in pursuing this music thing?
I've been singing all my life, but the first time I stepped foot in a studio was when I was like 17 years old. So it's been about like 6 years. But I've been signed to Heads Music for about two.
Okay, so who have you worked with? Like, have you stepped into a studio and saw somebody just like a fly on the wall that was like, wow?
I've seen a few celebs, but I'm working with Dave East. I'm on his latest project, Kyrie Chanel.
Okay.
Number 13, Slow Down.
Track to number 13?
Yep,
you got to know the number.
Right.
Send them directly, skip 1 through 12, go to track 13. That's you.
No, it's a dope project.
It's a dope project?
Check it out, yeah.
Okay, cool. And then who do we have next?
We have Allyson.
What up, Allyson?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey,
my name is Allyson Casado.
Allyson need a hair product for a sponsor.
She
knows with them curls.
Where
are you from?
Well, I'm from New York City, born in Brooklyn, raised in East Harlem.
Brooklyn, raised in East Harlem. Okay. Yeah. And you've been singing for how long?
All my life. Grew up in the church, sang in the church.
Are you going to be singing righteous music for us?
Righteous music for you guys today, if that's what you guys want.
How did y'all get with this guy? How does this happen?
Well, for me, I started working actually at Heads Music, and honestly, it was just God how that all just came about.
Amen.
The CEO, Madeline Nelson, took me one day to the studio. They asked me to demo a song. I sang, and then from there, it was just history. Like,
that's what
just God. So.
It seemed like Jazzy might have extorted you or something. Like, you know,
hit me with that Bronx, you know what I mean? Yo, that Bronx pressure.
Yeah, boom. Okay, let's do it. Let's try to call Suzette. Is that her?
If I was president.
Yeah. Hello?
Yo.
I know. I'm all right, but you on air right now.
Hi,
Sway.
Sue. Hi, Sue.
What's up, Sway?
Hey, Sue.
Yes.
Can you recognize this other voice?
Keep talking.
One time. Two time. Yo. Yo, Sue.
Yes, sir.
I said, look, I'm out here. I'm on the reel. I come in sway. I'm just tired of taking this pressure. Everywhere I go, all don't everybody want to know is there going to be a Fuji, whatever.
She said, don't do it.
I'm just telling you what they're telling me. No, I said. I don't got the plug.
Hey, Sue, I'm asking them if they could just get in the studio together, whether it's a Fuji project or they just make money, but make music together. Is it possible?
Why are y'all doing this to me?
I love you, Suzette.
Yo, Sway, really?
Yeah, I'm just, you know, we start talking Sue. About, man, Sue, I just love the music, Sue. I just love the music.
Yeah.
Just pass the word.
Possible, right?
Huh?
They said
anything is possible.
Yes, anything is possible. That's good enough for me. So, all right.
Sorry, Sue. I'll call you later.
All right, Suzette. Love you, Suzette.
Tell El Boogie we said what's up. And what a perfect time to go into song, Clef. Can we do something, man?
Oh, let's see. We can't.
Then before we play the ring, okay, I want to hear these. Like, you can put headphones on if you guys you want to hear.
You ready, Bronx?
Bronx, wow.
Let's get him.
We are lovers true and through, and though we made it through the storm, baby, I want you to realize I really want to put you on. I've been searching for someone to come and satisfy my needs. Won't you be my inspiration? Be the real love that I need. Real love. Clap. Come on. I'm searching for a real love, someone to set my heart free. Real love, I'm searching for a real love. Real love, I'm searching for a real love. Yeah, okay.
Don't stop, though.
Don't stop. Nah, we keep going, man.
You want to jump in?
Rock, get that girl a round of applause.
Thank you.
You want to jump in, Allyson? Go ahead, Allyson. Start anything. I'll follow you. This is your microphone.
Should I do a gospel?
You're right on the spot. Do whatever you feel.
Go ahead, Allyson. Welcome to Sway in the Morning. It don't count till you come here.
All right. I know I've been changed. Oh, I know I've been changed. Oh, I know I've been changed. The angels in heaven done signed my name. The angels in heaven done signed my name.
Man, what the hell is going on? Clef, move over. Put them in this seat real quick. I got that down for a second.
Thank you.
My gosh. Dang. All right, we're going to come back. Clef, man, since I got you here, man, I want to see if I can get you to do a Five Fingers of Death up next. Sway in the Morning, Shade 4-5. This is Wyclef Jean.
Jove?
Juve, baby.
Juve.
Yeah.
Ça passe.
No, no, it's cool. You know, y'all, you gotta have the island man sometime with them languages.
Well, you
I remember when I was like Guantanamo. My dudes in Brooklyn was like Guantanamo. I like, bro, it's Guantanamo. I had to get into the whole poem with them.
Yeah,
man.
But when you look at guys like my man in Canada, Tory, Tory Lanez, even Flo Rida, some of these guys who've gotten a lot of success, and I think you kind of laid the blueprint for a lot of folks' success, blending that island sound with that hip-hop sound, with that mainstream sound as well. How have you been affected? I'm going to pivot real quick because we're in this, such a political era and with recent immigration bans. How do you feel about some of the executive orders that have come down from our president, and how will that affect people from Haiti or people who are here from Haiti?
Well, the first thing, I want to commend President Obama for the Marcus Garvey pardon.
Okay.
You know, that was so, so important, because the way they did Marcus Garvey, infiltrated the organization, had him deported. Basically, here's a man, all he was trying to do was let black folks know, like, you can create trade, you know? J. Edgar Hoover did not agree with that. So it's so important, which leads us into the new world era. Fugees is short for refugees.
Yeah.
I've had people from my family came over on a boat. Some made it, some didn't make it. My parents came over. And when they did, I lost my pops. Of course, he passed now. But I remember the immigration laws were different. And I wouldn't be here, man.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be in America. And a lot of the swag we get in America would not be in America. A lot of the good food we get, a lot of the mixed dancing, that wouldn't be here. So once again, it's important that we treat people fair. And what I want people to understand is you can march till you're blue in the face. This is so important. And marching is so important. But you got to have a point of this is what we're marching for, and everybody got to be on the same page. And every celebrity that come on that stage got to be on the same page, right? Because what happens is we do this for real. I stopped everything. I was like, forget money or anything. I'm going to go run for president of my country. You know, they can give me a modern day lynching however they want to try it, but my people will never turn on me. So when you got these women that organize these powerful marches, and celebrities show up, always keep in mind, you have CNN, you got Fox News, you got the news in the media, and they're going to use the celebrity soundbite to basically run that week. And it's important that celebrities that come to these march understand, at the end of the day, watch what you're saying. Because what you say is going to determine whether if the courts are going to take these people seriously for the legislation and the policy. So it's important. Like this, because, you know, what they said, their new thing is celebrities don't know how to move the needle. So at the end of the day, politicians use celebrities all the time for exactly what they want. But celebrities don't know how to use the politicians.
That's real.
Wow.
Right?
Let that
sink
in.
Yeah. Let you feel me?
Yeah.
So I commend all of the women that marching. I commend the people that when I landed at Kennedy Airport, that was like, we don't agree with this and we're going to march. At the same time, these people are so serious to be standing out there in the cold, for people to be bringing their kids out in the cold. So it's important that we understand that they're marching for legislation, for policies, and all of the signs that they're putting up. You know, let's hold the mayors accountable, the senators, like, you know what I mean? Because right now, there's a lot of power that we have. Even though they be like, yo, the country's divided. If you really pay attention, we're so awakening.
Yeah.
So strong right now.
So strong. Wyclef Jean.
Yo,
Juve.
You hit it on the dot, baby.
Got it, baby.
Yeah, you hit it
got
on
it,
the dot.
Well done, Swag. Wyclef, even though you're not president of Haiti, it still feels like in the U.S. you are president of Haiti. That's how people view you. And I'm wondering, did you have at all a relationship with Q from Worldstar, who is also a fellow Haitian?
Oh, matter of fact, that's deep. The minute he passed away, I put up, not only I did the gram, but I also commended Jay. You know, because, you know, Q took Jay under as a mentor. I've had conversations with Q when I was running for president. Q protected me when they was trying to come at my foundation, try to accuse me of all kind of lies. Q called me on the phone, was like, yo, I understand what they trying to do to a brother. I'm going to protect you. I'm going to put this banner up here in World Star. They are going to. So we've always had, you know, incredible conversation.
Wow.
Talk. He, you know, as a leader, I understood what he was doing. He was just fascinated by what I was doing and always was like, yo, when could I go to Haiti? And he never really saw me as an entertainer, because our conversations was more, he was like, you know, you're the president of Haiti. You know, those was the conversations that we had. So I was, like everyone, I was definitely like shocked, you know, when that happened to him.
Right.
Wyclef Jean is here. New music.
Yo.
The album is called Juve.
Yo.
And then in this particular song, The Ring, you let people know that you still got it.
I schemed them.
You schemed
them. I had to go back to the Flatbush scheme mixed with New Jersey.
I peep game.
You know I had to bully it.
I saw it.
I had no choice.
In the second verse, you went from A to Z.
Scheme.
And then by the time you got to the second verse, the first verse, he eased you in it. You know, uh-huh. The smile in my face behind my back, they hate us. But like Bernie Mac said, I ain't scared of you, mother. You know,
I'm trying
not to curse as much this year.
Yeah.
Damn, Jazzy, I'm trying not to curse. What do you suggest? You're from the just kind of bleep, yeah, censoring myself. Thank you. And in the second verse, he does it from A to Z. And I think Clef and I have been doing this since the early 90s.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
When the Fugees first came out and they came to the Bay.
Okay.
And they came on KML, Sway Tech, world famous wake up show. We looked him in the eye. We looked Pras in the eyes. We looked Lauryn in the eyes and said, all that sounds great. But at the end of the day, do you have bars? Remember that, Clef?
Facts.
I
thought you had an instrumental.
Well, we got something better than that. We got the Five Fingers of Death.
You are now entering the Five Fingers of Death.
DJ Wonder plays five unique beats meant to test your lyrical stamina.
I saw the look in his eyes. This guy is crazy.
Many have tried.
I'm the best. This is just another chance for me to prove it.
But many have failed.
Give me some hip hop.
It's the Five Fingers of Death.
Ladies and gentlemen, Five Fingers of Death. Before it was even called the Five Fingers of Death, he was stepping up to the plate. You can sell as many records as you want, make as much money as you can, stand to as many celebrities that satisfy you. But it doesn't satisfy us unless we know you got bars. Are you a hyena?
Hyena!
Wyclef Jean.
Yeah, I pay attention, y'all. Five fingers of death. Yeah. Listen, Sway.
Yeah.
My life started out in a small village. I ate dirt from the floor, homie, no kidding. I ain't had no kitchen. Grandma said, pray to Christ. This Jesus baby barely had a bag of rice. My life started out, I was belly two. Papa flew to the States, searching for the golden goose. No work papers, officers raid the underground. They try to get him, man, he took off like a greyhound. His life, he got hunted like a groundhog. Sting operation in illegal alien in New York. But like the king, my daddy had a dream. 10 years later, I was sitting up in Brooklyn. That's all right, I'm gonna get to the Garden Gates, New Jersey Drive. I landed in the Garden State. I found myself machete in my right hand in front of the Chinese store, hemming up a young man. He hit my brother with a sucker punch. That was like they playing CeeLo, used to gamble on the cockfights. I got nothing to lose. I'm cool G when I rap about these ill street blues. Listen, my Diddy Biggie shooters, they little like Kim. And I ain't no joke, but I rock him. I used to slap box in front of the project elevator. The way I rock a fella, you gon' think I'm Sean Carter. Yup. Sway like, man, he going in. You writing my bars, ghostwriters from within. Yup. Told me y'all should be reminded I'm a mother freaking Fuji and my score has not been broken. Yup. Said, y'all should be reminded I'm a mother freaking Fuji. Listen, Sway, though it darkens behind the curtains, despite the burdens, I'm still a Spartan at heart, though they want to see me in the garden. After the choir, sing the songs with the church organs. Is there a heaven for a Jeep? Tupac the bishop, because for the juice, even Dougie Fresh will get a little precious. Word from the wise, think before you speak. Bruce Leroy ain't really catch bullets with his teeth. I seen the locks come out with no Mr. Sheeks, just a dread with magazine, and then they Maxi Priest. Listen, life is brief, we come and go like leaves. Apache Indians, we all achieve keys. But I can't stand to see another COP. Nope, take another life of a KID, nope. And I can't stand to see another NUT. Execution style on the NYPD, LAPD. Everybody frightened, cause when the storm come, anyone could get hit with lightning. Fast forward, homie, earthquake hit the H. Picking up the dead, no mask up on my face. Listen on Oprah, boy, when you see me weep, that's kids have seen a baby brain man on the concrete, boy. Seen a little boy blue, lose his legs. No hospital around, y'all, I watch him bleed to death. You would cry too if you had scarred face eyes. I never seen a man cry till I seen a man die. On Dave Chappelle, I said I wanted to be president. It ain't a joke, man, I really wanted to be president. Man of Haiti, I wanted better policy. I started yelling Haiti, they tried to J. Edgar Hoover me. Those with a third eye could see the truth through the lies. You know how it go. You're baptized, crucified, and then you rise, 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 then you rise. Hey, Sway, man, yeah. Welcome to my resurrection.
Right.
Like Pac, they try to hit me at the intersection.
Right.
Been to hell and back, I felt heaven's love. Uh-huh. I shook the hand of the devil, it felt like lava gloves. Looking back, I was raised in the West Side Story. The glory, who gonna make it first to purgatory? For the yay, seen some masked up in the day. Turn to the lion, just so they can hunt the prey. My old man told me, don't fall for the peer pressure. Before you know success, you gonna meet failure. What if Martin Luther stayed in the room, never stepped foot in the balcony? What if they had a bulletproof car instead of a drop top for Kennedy? Malcolm did this speech, what if I sat amongst the congregation? So when the boys can get your hands in my pocket, the five shots, the assassins sway. Hey, hey. Nothing new under the sun.
Talk
what if
him.
I had put blank in Marvin Gaye's father's gun?
Talk
now what if
him.
Y'all knew the truth before sending your kids to war? I tell y'all, that man didn't care about Iraq, man, he cared about the oil. Now what if I could go back in time and I raped 9-11, dip to the Bahamas and put Aaliyah's luggage in a 747, dip to Paris, put all the paparazzi in a slammer. So that way that night they would have never chased me since Diana. Favorite singer's Bob Marley, never been to his show. But what if the cancer never spread cause he cut off his toe? I'm with the Bobo Dreads in Jamaica, they like Pastor Chalice. Bomb so strong the guards get in contact at Buckingham Palace.
Ah, Wyclef Jean, ladies and gentlemen. Five figures of death. Let me look in the camera. You've been hoodwinked. You've been lured in. Look behind me. That's what a master is. A master of the mic. A master of ceremonies. This is a true MC. A hyena, ladies and gentlemen. You whack rappers, I despise you. You can't come near him. You couldn't burn him with a candle. Wyclef Jean, give him a round of applause.
Wow.
I haven't felt that this way so far this year. What the hell? Hey,
Listen, man, you see the bar game up, baby.
The bar
up. You know, I knew how I had to come, you feel me?
Yes.
And that's taking time out, going back to that black and white notebook, focus, you know what I mean? Writing that 60 bars. So you already know the training is real simple, man. It's called 100 bars a day, you know what I mean? That's the clip. You get that, you all good. When you see me, we could battle rap all day and have fun. You know what
Wyclef is ready to battle rap.
Yeah.
It's nothing to it, man. Wyclef,
you know, that's the fun. It's that's the exercise of the mind, you know?
You got to do that. Stay sharp. Ladies, give out your social media.
Jazzy Amra on every social platform, Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, JAZZYAMRA, and Twitter, so follow me.
Okay, is that your real last name?
No.
What does Amra mean?
Amra means princess in Arabic.
Okay, yeah. Okay, Amra, all right.
Okay, you all can follow me on Allyson Casado, AllysonCasado on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.
They got music coming soon?
Definitely music coming soon. And this Saturday at Terminal 5 this Saturday, we celebrating the 20th year anniversary of the carnival.
Wow.
Jeez. This Saturday.
Congratulations.
Definitely. So y'all could definitely go on wyclef.com, get tickets. The show is going to be insane.
Uh-huh.
I have a lot of, I don't know, man. I think the guests that I have coming, it don't exist. Because, you know, coming from like the political world and the music world is going to be a very diverse fan base. We got a big production coming in to produce the carnival. So look out for that. And we, as Heads Music, very excited with the merger with E1. So this Saturday, if you ain't doing nothing and you want to come to the ocean, if you ain't go to Eastern Parkway, and you missed that, so just meet us at Terminal 5 at 9 o'clock. We're going to get crazy.
And you can get Juve. It's out.
Oh yeah, Juve's out. They could pre-order that on iTunes.
Okay.
And get ready. You know what I mean? This is the warm up. And the most exciting thing about Head's music, when they came to get me, the CEO was like, "Man, look what you did for Beyonce, Lauryn, Mary J, all of that. We have a flow of young talent, mm-hmm. and we know that you about that roar. Like, we show up with a guitar, the girls are just singing. Ain't no tricks, ain't no nothing.
Yeah.
So for us, that part of the label is missing. So we want to be responsible for that artist development, that passion to bring mm-hmm. some of that energy back. So merging with, you know, E1 definitely was a great move for us.
Well, I'll tell you this, because we get thousands of artists that come through here. We give a lot of people opportunity, and I always tell them, don't come until you're ready. And a lot of that, I'm really saying, develop your craft mm-hmm. before you show the world.
Right.
And I know you've been developing your craft for 6 years. Yeah. And your father, so whose father? Your father is pastor. He's a pastor. Yeah. So you've been in that world developing your craft with your dad, yeah. right? And now you signed on with him. So yeah. So when we said go ahead and do something, you notice it wasn't no hesitation, mm-hmm. and they knew how to sing in the right key. Which is unusual right. nowadays. So congratulations. I'm looking right. forward to see. Come up here when it's all set and ready, and we can interview you guys and give you a full-fledged interview. Okay? All right? Come up here first, so don't play yourself.
Hey.
All right. Thank you, ladies. All right. Wyclef Jean, ladies and gentlemen.
Family.
This is The Ring. We got the A&R room up next with Rich Nice. Maybe Wyclef will join us.
It's Sway in the morning. Only
from Shea 45.
Kiddo!